going on with the weather. This past weekend, Landon, here he is in the Zoom room. This past weekend was rather interesting. It was Saturday morning. I was like, I don't think I'm going to be able to exercise, but then absolutely beautiful weather on in the afternoon.
Then yeah, it was definitely one of those.
Yeah. Well, first of all, are you in a nightclub? You've got all of that neon and all that black light there. So,
you know, I wish I was in a nightclub. This is my home office. This is where I work when I'm not at the office. And okay. It's actually a holiday for me, so it's Columbus Day. So I'm
well, if you need a good DJ, Joser here is available for hire.
I will keep that in mind, especially when the Christmas season rolls around. It's gonna be a lot of partying and the lights going on over here.
He does a fantastic mix of Frosty the Snowman.
Oh, that's awesome! Rocking around the Christmas tree. Actually, I have a Christmas tree. I just got it at Home Depot yesterday, so I'm getting started. And also, it's never too late in the morning for a hot cup of coffee.
Very nice. Well, so, well, with all of that time that you have to like to kind of plan and get ready for, you know, the Yuletide season and everything like that, I'm assuming that that means the weather is relatively stable.
You know, it's a tight fit because there's so many things going on. It's hardcore wet season right now. We have a tropical system to our west, a tropical system to our east. That came up, was upgraded, a disturbance near Wake Island was upgraded to now tropical storm. So there's a lot of stuff going on. I've got an off-island trip coming up. I'll be flying out Thursday for a week and a half for a conference. And then I may be off-island for another couple weeks in November. So as far as what I can really get my house straightened up for Christmas, it might be Thanksgiving. So I'm not going to be up with the burr months. I usually would start having stuff going up around September. And obviously, we're already into mid-October now, and I'm going to be way behind the curve. So,
well, you've got 2 months Santa arrives, so I don't think he's going to hold it against
you. I know. I'm feeling the pinch right now. I'm feeling the crunch time, so we'll get to it. But, yeah, speaking about the weather, Saturday was an interesting morning. We had all those widespread showers and thunderstorms across Guam and the Rota, less activity to the Tinian and Saipan, but Guam got hammered with heavy showers and thunderstorms Saturday morning. Then it cleared up nicely throughout the rest of the day, and then it was not so bad that night and then on into Sunday. But as we were discussing last week, it's going to be more fragmented, episodic, and you're going to have periods of showers and thunderstorms, and it's going to be not so bad for a number of hours with some peaks in sunlight. And that's what we had over the weekend. And then Sunday came, and I think I mentioned it toward the end of the week that this overall pattern is going to be changing as the influence of that large monsoonal system to our west pulls away. And then we get more into the influence of stuff to our east. We're going to be in a dead zone. And that's where we were on Sunday, that we were in that dead zone between two large weather features. And we had very light winds calm over the island. That induced the island convection that we saw yesterday. And so when we have those light winds, you get that daytime heating over the island, you get that convection. And it nailed parts of central Guam, Ataloop, Anigua, Asin, Petey, Agate. All those areas were hammered. Yesterday afternoon, we had about 3.5 inches of rainfall over Upper Heights in about an hour and a half time frame. That's significant rainfall in such a short period of time. Jigo, northern parts of Guam, did not see the action. Just light showers across parts of Dedede, maybe briefly heavy at times, but that was passing. The highlights, again, were, again, parts of Guam, north-facing near Anigua, Agatnya, and then on down towards the south. Parts of western Guam.
Yeah, so probably the part that concerned people the most, because even, you know, your colleagues over at Civil Defense and Homeland Security, they were mentioning that how that strip of road going from PD all the way down to Sumai, like, you know, heading towards Polaris Point and everything like that, flooding once again over there.
Yeah, Polaris Point, they took a lot of standing water yesterday. I was actually riding down there on my way to Agate to see how they were faring down there after the initial burst of rainfall. And Polaris Point was nearly impassable for northbound lanes, and then some of the southbound lanes were starting to take on water. So traffic was backed up, and when in doubt, don't go out in that water because it may be too deep for your car unless you have like a raised vehicle or a Jeep Wrangler. I was at my Wrangler yesterday, and that did pretty well. But even then, I'm not going to take that outer lane where it's going to be most deep. So the other thing, I'm going to open up the picture, and this is what we're looking at this morning. This is that departing monsoon system that's now Tropical Storm Campasu, making a pass close to northern Philippines. But that wind field is huge. It's enormous there. And there's that wind field. This is the JTWC warning graphic for Tropical Storm Campasu. These outer rings, those are tropical storm force winds encompassing southern Taiwan and northern Philippines. Very large system that we're looking at over there in the Philippines. And that's moving away, much to the favor of Palau, where they've been hammered for several days with intense rainfall, winds, waves, seas, surf, and numerous mudslides across the island. So they are assessing the mudslides in several places across Palau where roads are impassable.
Yeah,
real quick,
Len, I know you said you've got a lot of friends down there in Palau, and you said, you know, you've been in constant contact with, you know, your colleagues down there. Have they been able to unmoor the ships? Because you were saying that, you know, conditions were so bad that they had basically had to, like, lock down, like, a lot of the boats, and it really affected, you know, people that were mariners.
Yeah, they were taking things very cautiously where they're parked, where they have their boats anchored in the harbor. And so they were in some fairly safe shelter. So I've not heard any problems from the boat captain that were partnered up with the Weather Ready Nation, the Rim Nativa ship. But they fared pretty well. And if anything, the captain seemed to be enjoying it, just rocking and rolling with the swell. So they were safe and had good anchorage there. So what we're looking at for today, not so bad this morning, just some spotty showers. Our forecast does call for scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. But we have this upper level feature right here. This is what I'm concerned about for later today. Not going to be so bad this morning with spotty showers, but as this upper level feature comes closer, you see these highlighted colors. Those are heavier showers and thunderstorms. We're going to be seeing that come in our way. This is the other storm, Tropical Storm Namtoon. I think that's the correct pronunciation of that. That comes from Lao PDR. And that's going to be moving generally towards our west-northwest and keep well north of us. Once that happens, it's going to reinvigorate the monsoon flow across the region, and that's going to bring the winds back down towards the southwest and the south by the end of the week. Hopefully, it'll keep the moisture up there, but this is the water vapor showing the vast abundance of moisture across the region, all those white colors. We are in a very wet pattern out there, so... Yeah, that's what we're looking at for today. This is the graphic for Tropical Storm Namtoon, and it's going to keep away from us. No threat to the Guam or the CNMI as it keeps well to our northeast. But we could see some hazardous surf arrive from that later in the week or in this weekend.
Yeah, I was just about to ask because, you know, Tomas is in the Zoom room right now, and he's actually in quarantine up in Saipan. So he's about 100 miles north of us and everything. But so Guam and the CNMI, both, like, throughout the Marianas, we should be okay from this this weather formation, right?
Yeah, that's correct. This is going to keep well away from us. We're going to be watching it closely as long as it's in our area. And like I always say, anything that's east of us, I like to keep a very close eye on it because deviations do occur, but this one looks pretty solid. The models have been very consistent, keeping it well to our northeast and making that curve well into the North Pacific. So locally, no significant threats as far as tropical cyclones. But we do have a flash flood watch currently in effect through Tuesday, and that's really to highlight the risk of mudslides, especially with any subsequent heavy rainfalls that we're going to have in the coming days. And I think for us, that's going to be more this afternoon, evening, as that upper level feature comes and then brings a better chance of showers and thunderstorms, and also a high surf advisory and a high risk of rip currents along west facing reefs through 6 a.m. Tuesday. So keep that in mind if you're going to be swimming out along the west side of the island through tonight and tomorrow morning, the hazardous surf over there.
All right, guys, so you are getting insider information from the authority and the guy that knows more about this stuff than anybody, because things may look good. You go outside, it's a nice typical island day. You got a nice breeze. You got the nice sunshine coming down to you. But trust me, there is a lot going on as far as the weather system and everything like that, and we're fortunate to have guys like Landon. Okay, well, Tomas, why don't you jump on in this, because he's saying it's actually raining up in the CNMI.
Yeah,
Landon Tomas is here, and he's... Like I said, he's in quarantine in the Pacific Star up there and everything like that. So I'm sure he's keeping an eye on this as well.
Yeah, it's raining here. Welcome to some gray clouds. It's still gray. And so good to get your weather report, Landon. Thanks so much.
Yeah, you're very welcome. Enjoy Saipan.
Thanks, Landon.
All right, we'll talk to you soon. Enjoy the nightclub, man. Tip your waitress.
Yeah, absolutely.
There you go.
All right, 8:26.
Nothing I like better than Yuletide spirit and neon lights, man. That's an 80s Christmas.
Quite
story.
A one, too, Jason. 8:26, brought to you by Docomo Pacific. That's our work week weather with Landon Idlet from the National Weather Service. We're taking a quick break and coming back with Tomas Maglotnia. All the way live from the CNMI, next on The Link. Good morning.
We know you're tired of hearing about COVID-19. Some of you are probably wondering whether this